Murder, She Said, is a 1961 comedy murder mystery suitable for family viewing. The film has a rating of parental guidance. It is a first of a series of four films starring Margaret Rutherford as Miss Marple, which are inspired by various novels of Agatha Christie. Miss Marple is a perfectly harmless old lady who, while being a passenger on a train, witnesses the murder of a woman in a train travelling alongside hers on the parallel track. But when she reports this to the authorities, nobody seems interested. No body has been found, and Miss Marple is clearly deemed some dotty old biddy and far from a reliable witness. But having just witnessed the murder, Miss Marple is of no mind to let it pass, and so she resolves to investigate this matter herself. Together with her good friend Mr. Stringer, she checks along the railway track, trying to establish just where the body of the murdered woman just might have disappeared to. Soon enough, she comes upon a place where she thinks the body was likely thrown from the train. But how to follow up on that line of inquiry? Well, it so happens that the large house, the grounds of which lie next to the railway track, is looking for a maid. Never one to shirk a challenge, Miss Marple applies for the position. She enters a house populated by a nervous young woman, her too-clever-by-half nephew, a brutish-looking groundsman, and the ever-curmudgeonly patriarch, Luther Ackenthorpe, who is played rather memorably by James Robertson Justice. It does not take long for Miss Marple to find the dead woman's body, stowed away in one of the outhouses. The police are called, and it emerges that other members of the family had been visiting on the weekend that the body was dumped from the train and hidden on the property. Soon enough, the theory takes hold that the dead woman was the French widow of another family member who died in the war. Had one of the family disposed of her, seeing her as a rival to the inheritance of the family fortune? The police asks all to gather at Ackenthorpe Hall so they can be questioned. So now the rogues' gallery is expanded further with a variety of heirs to the old man's fortune. With every move they make, the assembled family members look as suspicious as can be. Amidst it all is Miss Marple, sleuthing for all she is worth. The exasperated Inspector Craddock would of course love nothing more than for Miss Marple to retire from the case, now that she has succeeded in convincing the police that a murder did in fact take place. But finding it impossible to convince the old lady to leave, he decides not to blow her cover in case she comes up with any more clues. Well, it isn't long until further members of the family begin to bite the dust. Ackenthorpe Hall turns out to be a dangerous place indeed. But just who is doing the killing? There is Emma Ackenthorpe, the nervous daughter, played by Muriel Pavlo. Emma Ackenthorpe just so happens to be having an affair with the family doctor. Surely Luther Ackenthorpe, who needs no less than two walking sticks to get about, could not be the murderer. Or could he? What about Cedric Ackenthorpe, brought to life by Thorley Walters? Or Harold Ackenthorpe, played by Conrad Phillips? Then there's that boy, Alexander, played by Ronnie Raymond. He seems a little unsettling, a little knowing. Just what does he know? Ronald Howard plays Brian Eastley, the father of Alexander, so he's only tied to the rest of them by marriage. As though that's not enough, we have Joan Hickson as Mrs. Kidder and Michael Golden as Hillman, that barbarous-looking groundsman. But if you must know, my money was always on the doctor. Why? Well, this chap, played by Arthur Kennedy, is American. If that isn't sufficient reason to be a murder suspect, I do not know what is. Now, I will not give the game away. If you want to know who did it, you need to watch the film. And a word of advice, don't believe any of the liars in the comment section. Anyhow, as we all know, murder mysteries are a penny a dozen. So why watch this one, or any of the other three of this series? Because this one is the quintessential Miss Marple film. In fact, all four of them are. There have been plenty other attempts, including entire television series. But nobody has ever matched Margaret Rutherford. She is to Miss Marple what Basil Rathbone is to Sherlock Holmes. Hers is the greatest characterization of the lady amateur sleuth ever. On top of that, she is very funny and downright lovable. Her Miss Marple is an eccentric, confident pensioner who knows a wrinkle or two and doesn't like being dismissed as some silly old woman. In this particular film, she is perfectly matched by James Robertson Justice, whose cantankerous character is set in his ways and unwilling to let some old maid attempt to change his way of life. The two of them clash beautifully.
There is one thing I cannot tolerate, and that is impertinence.
Well, we should get on admirably. Neither can I.
Everything about this film is a delight. It does not take itself too seriously. The grand characters of Rutherford and Robertson Justice are given plenty of room, and the whole thing is just a joy to watch. There are creaky floorboards, power outages, thunderstorms, and a marvellous female scream when a body is discovered. But it's a perfectly innocent film. There is no gore, nobody gets disemboweled. It's just 1.5 hours of fun and suspense. A game of Cluedo brought to life, if you will. I, for one, still find it hard to believe that Margaret Rutherford only ever made 4 of these films. So impressive is a representation of this character. You feel you know her so well, there must have been at least 10 movies made. But I guess it shows what can be accomplished if you have great actors to work with. Watch out for Miss Marple's eccentricities, and in pretty much every one of the films, there is a revelation of her having achieved some major accomplishment in her youth. In this one, I trust it is her having won the Ladies' Golf Open Handicap in 1921. All these things, of course, are perfectly ludicrous, but they add to the glorious confection that is Margaret Rutherford's Miss Marple. When I recommend these Miss Marple films to you, dear viewers, believe me, it comes from the heart. They are the kind of fare you will find yourself watching over and over again. For whichever way you turn it, Margaret Rutherford as Miss Marple is an all-time British classic. That's all for now from the projection booth atop the Cyber Pass. Thank you very much, and goodbye.